Hello, hello everyone.
I am going to present a paper on evaluation of retroperitoneal tumor using CT. It was a cross-sectional study. Before starting, I would like to thank my professor, Dr. Nanjarat sir, Dr. H. N. Pradeep sir, Dr. Manu Pratap sir, Dr. Pratibha ma'am. Let's start with brief introduction. Retroperitoneum is a complex anatomical space in the body where a tumor grows often silently to a larger extent before even clinical presentation. Among the various imaging modalities, CT plays a vital role in evaluation of retroperitoneal tumors. It determines epicenter of tumor size, tumor composition, extent, vascularity, and effects on adjacent structure, helps in treatment planning, and therefore early and accurate diagnosis is crucial. Aim of my study is to evaluate various CT imaging findings of retroperitoneal tumor and to associate it with histological findings, materials, and methods. A cross-sectional study was done at Department of Radiodiagnosis, Mysore Medical College for a duration of 12 months. Study includes 30 patients. Each patient was subjected to plain and contrast and CT to characterize retroperitoneal tumors. The results were tabulated and evaluated descriptively by Microsoft Excel 2016. Let's briefly talk about few of the imaging features of retroperitoneal tumor. Here, first case showed a large heterogeneous lesion with non-enhancing area noted in retroperitoneum with negative big sign with the renal kidney, suggestive of it's not of renal origin. Next, move on to next case. Large heterogeneous lesion noted arising from the left kidney with positive big sign, suggestive of it's of renal origin. Histopathologically proven that it's a case of renal cell carcinoma. Another case showed well-defined large solid lesion with the predominant fat component noted displacing the liver anteromedially and right kidney inferiorly. Tissue diagnosis proved that it's a case of retroperitoneal liposarcoma. Another case showed multiple homogeneously enhancing lesions of varying sizes noted in preparaortic region encasing the AVC and aorta, giving an appearance of sandwich sign. It's a classical case of retroperitoneal lymphoma. Next, move to another case, multilocated thin-walled cystic lesion, non-enhancing cystic lesion noted in retroperitoneum, possibly abutting right kidney and displacing the adjacent structure. Tissue diagnosis came as retroperitoneal lymphangioma. Another case showed large heterogeneous lesion displacing the vascular structures, and there was evidence of intrathoracic extension displacing the right kidney inferiorly, and there was no non-visualization of suprarenal gland, giving an appearance of phantom organs in case of neuroblastoma. Let's come to results part. Here bar graph representing age distribution of the patient. In my study, there was peak incidence in 6th and 7th decade age groups. On the right hand side showed a tumor distribution, whether it's of renal origin, adrenal origin, periampullary origin, or primary retroperitoneal tumor. In my study includes 36.6% of cases were primary retroperitoneal tumors. Next, come to characteristics of the tumor: size, tumor composition, whether the lesion are solid or cystic, is there presence or absence of fat, calcification, necrosis in solid tumors, enhancement pattern, effect on adjacent structure in the formula of displacement, infiltration, vascular encasement, distant metastasis, benign versus malignant. In my study, 24 cases were malignant. My study was compared with the previous studies conducted by Chaudhary et al. And Stephen D. H. et al. These studies showed similar imaging features and concluded that CT plays an important role. I am interpreting my study. My study included 30 patients, out of which 17 were males, 13 were females, most common age groups seen in 6th and 7th decade people. Histopathologically confirmed radiological diagnosis in 26 cases, out of which 80 cases were malignant, 20 cases were benign. Among these, primary retroperitoneal tumor were the most common tumor, accounting for 36.6%. Among these, lymphoma was the most common tumor, followed by lymph nodal metastasis. Four other tumors were liposarcoma, extraadrenal neuroblastoma, paraganglioma, and lymphangioma. Majority of the tumor were solid. One exceptional case was cystic, it was lymphangioma. Most common enhancement pattern in my study is heterogeneous enhancement. Infiltration of adjacent organ was seen in 5 cases, vascular encasement in 7 cases, and distant metastasis in 6 cases. Let's come to discussion part. CT plays an important role in characterizing the tumor. This helps in narrowing down the differential diagnosis, therefore helping treatment planning. And malignant lesions were more common than the benign lesions. Similar findings were also seen in the studies conducted by Chaudhary et al. And Stephen D. H. et al. But the number of benign cases were in Stephen D. H. et al. Was less compared to my study. Both the above studies concluded that CD plays an important role in diagnosing the retroperitoneal tumors. Primary retroperitoneal tumor constitutes maximum cases in my study, accounting for 36.6% of cases, with 6 cases with 30, with lymph nodal mass being the maximum, accounting for 63.63%. Similar finding was noted in study conducted by Chinwan D. et al. The identification pattern and classification in the retroperitoneal tumor significantly shortened the list of differential diagnosis. In the study, 4 cases showed fat attenuation within the lesion, and 3 were benign, 1 was malignant, signifying that the fat was more commonly found in benign lesions. The presence of necrosis most commonly found in malignant tumors. My study includes 18 cases showed necrosis, out of which 16 cases were malignant, 2 cases were benign, which includes pheochromocytoma and paraganglioma. Vascular encasement is also a feature of malignant tumor. In my study, all 7 cases showed vascular encasement were malignant, which include lymphoma, neuroblastoma, periampullary carcinoma. Among the cases with periampullary carcinoma, 3 out of 5 cases had vascular involvement. Similar findings were seen in the study conducted by Lee E. S. et al. In my study, there were 3 cases of neuroblastoma, median age group of 1.5 years, in which 1 case showed intrathoracic extension. I am concluding my study. The basic purpose of my study was to use CT as an imaging tool to help arriving the accurate radiological diagnosis of retroperitoneal tumor based on various imaging characteristics, thus guiding in treatment planning. These are my references. Thank you.